Good morning, party people.
Welcome to The Breakdown with Nath and Johnny. Glad to have you back again for another potentially heavy banger.
I mean, the last two Bullet My Valentine tracks have been bangers. This is the new song, Shatter, off their upcoming self-titled album.
Mm. I was going to try and work a pun in there, like, I had too much Mexican last night and I shatter my pants.
Oh, I'm so glad you didn't say that.
Yeah, very lowbrow. Oh.
That's Johnny for you.
Didn't get there. Anyway, we're going to jump in. Yeah, super keen to hear this one. We've loved the last two tracks. Please like, subscribe, follow us on the socials, check out our merch. We also have a donate button if you want to help us out and throw a few dollars our way to help keep the channel going because YouTube hates us.
Put your headphones on, Johnny. 3, 2, 1... Very metal style.
Yeah, love that build. It's gonna break me, but that doesn't matter. Another crack,
watch me shatter. Oh! Oh! Oh, yes! Woo! Chunk City!
I realised the heavier the riff got, the more I rolled my sleeves up.
Fuck! A riff! You went to the end of the song, he must be just here. The tightest shoulders popping out. I love riffs!
That's gonna be great. Yeah. Anyway, continue. Dude,
yes, dude.
I am getting such Massive Machine Head vibes.
Oh, okay. Yeah.
Massive Machine Head vibes. That slow, just ba-na-na-na, and even the rest of it.
And then even the music of it, you know?
Yeah, the music and the vocals. Yeah, but no, I wasn't expecting that real slow, less metal sort of like riffage.
Yeah, there's a bit more space within it. It is a bit more down tempo, but also down tune. So it's heavy.
Oh, it's heavy as shit.
You know how heavy that is.
Heavy as shat.
Ah! I'm pausing the middle of the soul here. But this gives me Parkway Drives.
Yeah, yeah, I feel it.
Just
feel
it, like it. Even like more the Aya
era, yeah, because it's got the woes that they threw
as
in.
As well as the solos.
Shreddy, shreddy, shreddy. That last one was out of nowhere.
Yeah, I did like that.
Holy shit.
Tells you what, Johnny. We love a Wowo.
We do. We also love the fact that these dudes are back, like, heavier than ever, as far as I'm concerned. Heavier than ever.
That's all I'm worried about, what you're concerned.
Thank you. You're a very good friend.
That is my least favourite of the three songs we've heard so far, though, to be honest.
I'm going to agree.
Thank you!
But the other two were fucking phenomenal.
Yeah, like, that wasn't a bad song by any means. Of the three we've heard, that was my least favourite. Now, things that really pull that back in, the Wowo, I know we love a Wowo, but that was fantastic. That was a great thing. The like machine gun drums in that part as well was so good. There was that solo was
sick.
The
solo was great, yeah.
The riff was really good. I don't know.
It was lacking something vocally for me.
Yeah. 100%. There was no big moment apart from the, the end there.
Yeah.
There was nothing that stood out. Even when he went from the cleans into the screamed chorusy bit, it still didn't feel like a change. I don't know how to explain that.
No. It's like... We love it, I feel like... In a sense of dynamics, it was really cool that they had that sort of really pulled back and he was just doing that real sort of gritty, clean singing and big toms. And then it came into the big riff. But to sort of be a bit selfish, I guess I wanted a chorus after that or a vocal line or something after that was repetitive that you could grab onto that made it a little bit more memorable. That's my only gripe about the song, was that it just didn't hit the next level like the other two did.
Yeah, it didn't have that one big step-up moment. The big step-up moment was the Wowos, and that wasn't quite... Yeah, but having said that, they are back in a huge way. Songwriting, that was fantastic. He has such a consistently good voice.
Yeah, really, really good.
The production on it was really cool too.
Great production. Everything was crisp. Everything was clear. Everything came through. Nothing was sort of fighting for your attention, which is really good. I could have taken or left the film clip. It wasn't
I was just going to say, that could also be what's adding that to it for me. It was just him singing into a lens with something around and kind of they just added effects over it.
Yeah.
Now I get music videos, big production music videos take a lot of time and money, but I don't know. I just feel like that.
I feel like
after the past two, again, that one was just a little step back.
Yeah, and being this far into your career and having the career that they have had, such a big, successful career, I would have just thought maybe they, you know, no discredit to them, but maybe they might have known someone who could have done the song a little bit more justice with imagery and things like that. You know what I mean? Like the shattering of the glass and stuff was cool, but things like that, I feel, if that's all that's happening, get old a little bit quick.
Yes.
I also wasn't a huge fan of the lyrics on the screen in sense.
I don't mind lyrics on the screen sometimes because if it's done the right way, you're right. In that sense, maybe, I don't know, that just wasn't.
What did you guys think?
It seemed like a lyric video for me, like an animated lyric video almost.
Yes. Yeah.
Having said that, out of 10, what do you give that song?
I give that song probably a 7.
Yeah, great. That's what I would give it to.
Look at
strong.
What would you guys give it? Let us know in the comments below. Are you as excited for the album as we are? Because, you know, that was still a great song. And regardless, I'm super keen to hear it in an album sense and what else they put on
there. If that's a single as well, like that's generally they do like a song that's still like heavy but a bit more like radio friendly, that might be that song.
Yeah.
We might be in for more bangers.
Oh, we're definitely in for more bangers.
Oh, you didn't know we're in for more bangers. We'll see you guys next time.